Hi, my name is Joseph Mizrahi, and welcome to Sexual Orientation and You. But what do we mean when we say sexual orientation? For some, the matter of being homosexual, heterosexual, or bisexual is an issue of choice, something that one decides at some point in one's life. For others, the issue is biological, something we are genetically predisposed to. And yet, for others, it is more than biological, but something that we may someday be able to manipulate. The most recent study has caused quite a stir, and it all started on a farm.
Imagine a farm in Oregon. And on this farm, there is a male sheep called a ram. And a female sheep, also known as a ewe. The farmer has selected these animals for a very specific purpose. Because when a ram and a ewe fall in love and become intimate, they can produce a baby sheep. This makes the farmer money, which makes him happy. However, scientists estimate that between 8 and 10% of all rams have no desire for the ewe, but instead prefer to mount other rams. This means no baby sheep, which means no money, which makes the farmer sad, because he has to sell his farm. Farms all across Oregon were experiencing this problem, so they called a researcher at Oregon State University, Dr. Roselli. Dr. Roselli examined the sheep. He examined the rams. He even examined the baby sheep. This gave Dr. Roselli an idea. Dr. Roselli discovered that a sheep's sexual orientation was determined while in utero. A pregnant sheep with a certain hormonal imbalance will often produce a homosexual ram offspring. Dr. Roselli also discovered that the brain of a homosexual ram bears a closer resemblance to that of a female sheep than to the brain of a heterosexual ram. Dr. Roselli explained that by simply manipulating the hormone levels of a pregnant sheep, that he could ensure the production of a heterosexual ram. This means the ram will mate with the sheep, which will produce a baby sheep, which will make money, which makes the farmer happy, because he doesn't have to sell the farm. But Dr. Roselli couldn't help but wonder if his findings couldn't be applied to pregnant women and their human babies. Dr. Roselli stated in the media that his study, quote, also has broader implications for understanding the development and control of sexual motivation and mate selection across mammalian species, including humans.
The most recent controversy only erupted in the media when Dr. Roselli proclaimed that his results could be utilized in both sheep and human subjects. But was Dr. Roselli telling the truth, or was he merely being loquacious? In any matter, once the reports hit the newspapers, it wasn't long before they hit the blogs.
To a certain extent, all studies regarding the biological nature of sexual preference are controversial. Religious groups often wish to prove that homosexuality is not genetic and is against human nature. According to hatecrime.org, groups such as the Claremont Institute, the American Family Association, the Family Research Council, Americans for Truth About Homosexuality, and the preacher Pat Robertson have all referred to homosexuality as unnatural. On the other hand, many gay rights advocates have continually attempted to link homosexuality to both the natural world and human genetics in order to disprove the theory that sexual orientation is a choice. It was not long before conservative groups such as Focus on the Family began to oppose Dr. Roselli's research. However, soon the gay rights advocates were also upset at Dr. Roselli. People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals responded to Dr. Roselli's claim that these studies could be useful in human genetics. PETA began a campaign to protest the research. Many feared Dr. Roselli's study would lead to a modern-day eugenics, or breeding out, of homosexuality. Retired tennis star Martina Navratilova wrote a letter to Oregon State University in which she wrote, "How can it be that in the year 2006 a major university would host such homophobic and cruel experiments? For the sake of the many gays and lesbians who stand to be deeply offended by the social implication of these tests, I ask that you please end these studies at once." The controversy really made headlines when the Sunday Times of London published an article entitled "Hands Off Gay Sheep." The Times stated that the study could pave the way for breeding out homosexuality in humans, and that this study, quote, "raises the prospect that pregnant women could one day be offered a treatment to reduce or eliminate the chance that their offspring will be homosexual. The straightening procedure on humans could be as simple as a hormone supplement for mothers-to-be, worn on the skin like an anti-smoking nicotine patch." It was after this report that follow-up stories were posted in nearly every major newspaper. The controversy reached its height in thousands of heated discussions throughout the blogosphere. Between the conservative Christian community and the gay rights left, nearly no one was left defending Dr. Roselli or his research team.
The only problem with the stories in the newspapers and blogs? They weren't true.
Once Dr. Roselli was finally given the opportunity to defend his study, it became clear that not only was a great deal of the criticism unfair, it was also untrue. In fact, Dr. Roselli's research team did discover a similarity between homosexual ram brains and heterosexual ewe brains, but they did not implant devices in the sheep's brains. While they discovered a link between hormone levels of pregnant sheep and the production of homosexual rams, Dr. Roselli insists that there is far from conclusive evidence that this is the sole cause of ram homosexuality. And while it is true that some studies were conducted to see if these hormone levels could be altered, all tests attempted to create more homosexual rams, not breed them out. Most importantly, these tests were unsuccessful. Dr. Roselli's research was unable to increase or decrease the production of homosexual rams. Reports of potential patches worn by pregnant women in order to ensure heterosexual offspring are complete science fiction. In fact, the Sunday Times article entitled "Hands Off Gay Sheep" has since been removed from its online archives. While Dr. Roselli does not deny stating that his study could have potential human implications, he explains that the use of such language is common when scientists apply for grants. In fact, the mission statement of the organization that funds much of Roselli's research specifically looks for animal-based studies that translate to patient-oriented clinical research. With much of the misinformation coming from PETA, we must question their motives. Are they truly concerned with the well-being of the gay community? Or are they actually concerned with the 18 sheep that die per year in Dr. Roselli's research?
So what can we learn from this story today? Throughout all the media misrepresentations and all of this controversial research, perhaps we've learned less about sexual orientation and more about the negative impacts of the politicalization of the research process.
Okay. In recent years, research and scientific findings have become an increasingly political enterprise. But a vital aspect of the scientific process is the unbiased pursuit of facts. The politicalization of the research process has affected many of our modern-day scientific pursuits, from cloning to stem cell research to global warming. No matter how justified our ethical concerns, how can we search for truth if we declare entire areas of research taboo? Perhaps we should endeavor to recognize research as an entirely neutral pursuit. What we do with the scientific knowledge is open for ethical debate. However, the pursuit of that knowledge should certainly be less divisive.
Thanks for watching Sexual Orientation and You. These are issues we all should be thinking about. If not for the people, let's do it for the sheep. In the bomb, the bomb, the bomb. Who put the ram in the ram-a-lama ding dong? Who put the bop in the pop, shibop, shibop? Who put the dip in the dip, dip, dip? Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
ba 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 ba